आपसे भी गुजारिश है कि आप हमको बताएं प्रोग्रामेटिक बाइंग के बारे में.
सो प्रणव, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कांग्रेचुलेशंस फॉर पुटिंग दिस टुगेदर. आई नो इट वाज एन आइडिया 3 इयर्स बैक एंड यू मेड इट हैपन. सो प्लीज गिव सुपर्णा अ बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज. मिस्टर चुग, यू आर वॉकिंग इन नाउ. वी जस्ट प्लेड अ नेवी यू नो शोइंग द ज्यूरी प्रोसेस. उदय, आई एम टॉकिंग टू यू about mobile marketing. I spend most of my time on my mobile, either in the airline or...
Yeah, we saw that.
Yeah, so I think I'm a good target audience for the ads that your network serves. Me and Uday were chatting just before we came in and we were preparing for today. And I asked Uday one question and we'll start with that. I said, Uday, today less than 2% of the advertising spend are on mobile. They're likely, according to our report, they're likely to be 5% of overall advertising. In 5 years, if Uday had to predict, where would mobile marketing would be in terms of spend? Uday gave a very interesting answer.
I'll have to change my role and become an astrologer. But let's look at some of the numbers and exactly what I told you earlier. Today, the entire ecosystem of digital video, which I understand, or the space in which we are, the digital video ecosystem today has about 150, 180 million odd consumers. Different people say different numbers, but in that range. So if you're looking at about 150, 180 million users who are connected, 3G, 4G users across the country and have smartphones in their hand, that number, according to me, would go by at least 3x in the next few years. Will it be 4 years? Will it be 3 years? Will it be 5 years? We're talking of 500 million users. If we're talking of 400, 500 million users having smartphones and connecting to entertainment on their mobile or consuming
news, whatever,
entertainment news, whatever, through video, we're talking of a base of consumers which is almost 2x of what the entire US market is today. US market is about 200, 220 odd million users. We are talking of 400, 450 odd users in 3 to 5 years. The market size could be significantly larger. It could run into a couple of billion, maybe more than $5 to $7 billion. But that number is anybody's guess. I could be off by 100% on that. I don't think the number by itself is important. The important thing for us as platform owners and marketing solution providers is that will we be able to provide good solutions to our advertisers and our advertising partners at that point in time? Will the medium be large enough to be mainstream advertising, mainstream opportunity for advertisers? So I think that huge swing is what we will see. In the last 2 years, we've now seen that OTT and digital video has become mainstream for most advertisers. Most advertisers would put in money into, besides doing conventional marketing on print and television, would put in some part of their budget on digital. I've seen a lot of campaigns now going digital first. Mobile first. So we'll see lots of these things happening. The way advertising is done, the way advertising is targeted, just changes the minute you have a mobile in your hand. Remember, the mobile is the only entertainment device that we carry with us 24/7. Absolutely. There is no other screen in the history of the world that we have carried along with us to entertain ourselves. And this is the only screen that we carry along with us. So you have the ability to open any app, Sony Live or any other app, and say, I want to get entertained now.
Give me a number. If we are at let's say 1,000 crores of mobile advertising today. Some people say it's 1,200 crores, but let's say 1,000 crores, easy number. Where will be 3 years from now?
So my guess would be 5x from where we are today?
5,000 crores. So if the digital advertising is 20,000 crores,
yeah. And so this would be probably 30-40% of that.
Fantastic.
Maybe more.
So that's the kind of numbers we are looking at. By the way, we have Mr. Shroff amongst us. He's our keynote speaker. And the reason we got Mr. Shroff to be our keynote speaker, you know why? Because this award is called Maddie's and he's a Parsi. Bharat bhai, I'm trying to compete with you. At least you can smile. Give me a round of applause, right? So that actually came from him. I took his permission to crack that, Yeah. Coming back to mobile. Now, when I talk to investors, they say OTT is a very tough business model. So the, you know, how at some stage do you think OTT platforms will go pay? We're advertising led. So do you see a scenario in India where, say, if there is compelling content, I don't want to tell you what content, you know, cricket works, cinema works, news not sure because it's free to air. If there's compelling content, do you think in an OTT model, we'll go pay in India at some stage? Because if you look at the US or you look at the Europe, all three models are working, you know. Freemium is working, pay is working, and advertising led is working. So give us a peek into future. Where do you think the OTT market will go?
So let me answer the first thing. OTT business is a tough business to get in. Any media business is a tough business to get in. You know it better than
me. You came from a non-media business. Yeah. That's why you were here.
Yeah. So the media business is a tough business to get in. You know it better than anybody else. You've been around for a while. Any media business in India is a tough business to get in. Most businesses in India on the media side are run through advertising.
Right.
They're mostly advertising supported. My guess is, and our bet on this is that it would remain an advertising supported for a very long time, and it has nothing to do with the way it has a lot to do with the way the ecosystem is currently. In India, it's very difficult for people to collect money. The ability for us to collect money for an online service on a monthly basis is just an absolutely impossible task to do today. The friction on payments is significant. People who have products which are sold online will tell you how difficult it is to do that. There are friends who are here from the news sector. Ask them how much they make from subscription versus advertising or how many.
Of course,
no. So they'll tell you, you know, how difficult it is to do that. These are all advertising-driven businesses. Let me make it look slightly different. It's slightly different from the rest of the world also. The rest of the world, paying for subscription is an easy thing. Okay, it's part of people's habit to charge their credit card and allow a vendor to do a charge on your credit card on a monthly basis. How many services do we allow that in India? You don't allow your mobile, you don't allow your telephone company or your electricity company to do that. So how are you going to allow a news or an entertainment company to be able to charge you automatically on a monthly basis? You know, that requires a different set of trust. And
in the future, we'll possibly move towards that.
We possibly would.
But you're clearly saying
so
we'll be
in the foreseeable future, I see this as an advertising-driven business. I see this as a business where advertisers will be able to target their consumers far better. What mobile and digital allows is far better ability to target. It allows you to be zero wastage and get your consumers the way you want and provide him the message the way you want to provide.
Uday, we're doing this chat 10 days after the Vegas shooting, right? Today's 11th October. By the way, yesterday was World Mental Health Day. So I wish the President of America good mental health. So I just want to tell you that. But coming back to the Vegas shootings, while there is this debate about gun control and guns should be banned, and this debate about the Second Amendment, which is in the Bill of Rights of Americans, there's also a call for the video games, you know, especially America. The violence culture starts when a kid is young because he or she starts playing video games. Now, the reason I mentioned that, what about we are making sure we are letting a lot of offensive content for our kids to see. How are we dealing with that? You know, I know making money is very important. Being sustainable is very important for a business. And you help businesses grow through advertising. But what about the social impact of growth of mobile content? What are responsible players like you thinking about it?
So we are putting in various checks and balances in the system to make sure that the right content reaches out to the right users. So when you look at most of the OTT apps, and especially if you look at what we are doing on Sony Live, all the content that we think is not appropriate for anybody above 18 goes behind a paywall. It is clearly tagged as 18 plus. If it is not a paid content and we believe that this content is not available or should not be available to an 18 plus, there is an absolute warning which goes out saying this is content, it should not be viewed by somebody like this. Now, there is a huge difference between broadcast and an OTT app. The broadcast is a push technology. You're sitting in your bedroom and you're getting something. Therefore, you have very little control on what you're watching. It's coming to you.
This is a pull.
This is a pull technology. You're actually going through an app. You're actually clicking it. And trust me, if you have the ability to search and you have the ability to seek and find content, the internet can give you a lot more than what is available on some of our apps. So as responsible
content
players, we are setting the filters ourselves. We are making sure that we are following the law of the land and putting all these filters in place.
Uday, one of the game changers that is happening in the Indian advertising and Indian mobile and digital space is that Bark is starting to do video measurement. So if the consumption of video is happening on various platforms, till now it is not measured and hence advertisers don't really utilize it. It gets bundled, it gets given free. Do you think that measurement being done and it being put on the table will help in growth of this number that we are talking of?
So there are two ways I want to answer it. One, I think Bark or no Bark, today most advertising is being bought by advertisers on a real-time measurement basis.
Of course, there's
enough and more measurement available in the ecosystem. Most people today have been running digital businesses for 15, 17 years. I've been in this business for 17 years. We've been monetizing our platforms by very precise, very, very precise measurement techniques. Very sophisticated measurement techniques and targeting techniques are available and reporting techniques are available. That's not an issue. The issue that Bark is trying to resolve is an industry-wide template where everybody speaks the same language and everybody's measurability is comparable to the other.
Absolutely.
And therefore, we are using the same metrics across or we are using the same agency for that metrics. So I think that is what Bark is trying to resolve. Hopefully, when Bark brings in that thing, our realization and our outflow or our ARPUs coming in from our advertising will go up because they'll be far more authenticated, they'll far more be backed by people from the industry.
Give me the name of a platform that you look up to and say, wish I could build something like that. Because I know you're very entrepreneurial. You built Headhunters, which is a digital kind of, headhunting platform, if I can't find another word. What is one platform, either in India or in the US, that you look up to and say, if I build that, I'd be happy?
So, I think that's a very tough one, and it's not an easy answer to give, given that India is a very unique market. I don't subscribe to the theory of saying you must copy something which is running in the US or UK and bring it here, fundamentally because our Indian market behaves differently. So let me explain this slightly differently. We've got an AVOD ecosystem in India, which is an advertising-supported video-on-demand ecosystem in India. So video ecosystem in India is supported primarily by advertising. Nowhere in the world has the video-on-demand ecosystem reached this scale purely supported by advertising. Everywhere in the world, either it is supported by transactional, which is pay-per-view, which is the Apple equivalent model, where you pay for each piece of content, whether it's music or movies, and consume it. Or you have a Netflix kind of a model or an Amazon kind of a model, where you subscribe for a monthly get-all content kind of a service. The advertising-supported model in India is unique, and we are seeing those models both in India and China because the payment ecosystem is very different in India. The advertising-supported model...
SVOD is not going to work in India.
So I don't see that happening in the foreseeable future. I think India will remain an advertising-supported model, and we will see that grow at a very fast pace. And therefore, all the work that we are all putting in is to make sure that we become better supporters of the advertising ecosystem.
Uday, my last question before I bring the audience in. You know, the newspaper publishers sitting here, Pradeep Air, the other people. Do you think in future, all the newspapers have to become video platforms? Or is it too
dramatic? You're asking the wrong guy. I think they should have become video platform a few years back.
Right, no wonder Pradeep is making
sorry, sense. Pradeep, but yeah, I think there has to be a movement. There will be a movement in the way people consume content. The advantage that video brings is that it removes the factor of being able to read or not able to read. So if somebody is not able to read, he's surely able to listen and be able to comprehend. So it opens up a larger market. It opens up a larger market for consumption, and it opens up a larger market for the advertiser. So I think print or putting a lot of that will move to video at some point in time if this scale has to improve.
Thank you, Uday. I think at this point we can take two or three questions from the audience. If someone has a question, please raise your hand and tell us what you do and ask a Twitter-like question. So if there are questions, I can take them. Otherwise, I have one more question. I don't see. So I'll ask the question that I'll ask you is, you know, there is a, with online and mobile advertising growing, there are ad blockers that are growing. People, I don't know how many people in this room. How many of you have ad blocking technology on your phone? About 12 of them have raised, 15. We shouldn't have allowed them in, right? How did we allow you in next year? We'll check that. But jokes apart, as the advertising on mobile grows, and because it's a very personal device, individuals and consumers will find a way to avoid ads.
Yeah.
How do publishers like you are dealing with that? And how do you're educating advertisers to deal with that?
So I think this is a problem that is an industry-wide problem. There is no short-term solution to say how do you remove ad blockers. There are multiple ways of doing it. I have seen some publishers actually block consumers to consume content who have ad blockers. I think this is a cat and mouse game. This will not get sorted out in the short term. What we are seeing on Sony Live is our ad blocking numbers are significantly lesser. We are also seeing, because people are coming to us for entertainment, they're not seeing intrusive ads in a big way. I think what we are also seeing is advertisers are far more keen to put their content of their brands into the content. So the minute you start integrating the product into the content in an engaging way, you will find that the ad blockers or whatever it is, you'll circumvent a lot of it, and you're part of the content. So we encourage a lot of our advertisers to be part of the content and be part of what is happening in the screen rather than, you know, just focus on pre-rolls or mid-rolls or any other form of advertising. You be part of the content, it gives you far more value, it gives you far more credibility.
Fantastic, Uday. Please give Uday Sodhi a big round of applause
for being
a pioneer. And
Mr. Dwivedi had a question.
Yeah, Mr. Dwivedi.
Yeah, two quick ones.
Do you have a... No, this is not a... Two quick ones.
I think Anuragji, you asked how many people have ad blockers on their phone. I think about 12 people raised their hands. But if you ask how many people have iPhones, you'll realize that the number of ad blocked handsets is much larger because Apple ecosystem has an opt-out for ad blocker. So if you don't opt out, you are ad blocked to begin with. So I think all those who are with iPhones are already ad blocked to begin with. But my question
you should stop the sale of iPhones in India, basically. It saves some people a lot of money also, by the way.
So my question is actually to Uday. You know, Uday, you're right saying that video first is actually a strategy. When you look at most of the publishers who are in the traditional print domain who are heading into digital or mobile ecosystems, we are all going mobile first. And we realize that the audience is shifting there, and that is what it makes sense. However, we are seeing a dichotomy of audiences in a sense that there is a traditional audience that's been with us in print. And now when we move to digital, to get the same audience attracted is a challenge. How open are you or other OTT platforms in general, and I'm not specifically asking for Sony Live, but for all OTT platforms, to partner with traditional news publishers to allow them space on your side in a partnering model which makes sense for both of us? Because you come from an entertainment angle and we come from a news angle.
Let's do this outside and yeah. close this today.
Sounds like a good idea. Thanks.
Yeah. The, I hope we get a
fever enabling it. So, I think these walled gardens ideas on OTT are not going to work. Content has to be available at destinations, and we will find multiple. So, on Sonylu, for example, on the original content front, we've tied up with at least 15 different providers of content, and they're bringing their content onto our platform and sharing with their. So we're building not only a repository of our content, and that's the starting point. What we're doing is on Sonylu, we've got 6 hours, 8 hours of content that we create and put every day. Besides that, we are also bringing in third-party content and bringing it so that we are offering a larger variety or a bigger variety to the consumers. And when the advertising is happening, the advertiser then is able to target X content versus Y content because the intent is better captured by a variety of content. So our objective of doing a variety of content is to be able to capture more and more data and intent to target the campaigns better. At
Fantastic. That's a brilliant approach.
Pradeep, I just want to tell you that I'm a first generation entrepreneur. I've been in media long. That's how I lost my hair. But I went to we acquired Business World almost 4 years back, and I've been trying to raise money for digital play and build it bigger. So I met India's possibly largest legitimate investor in media. There are other bigger people in India who have a pie in every media company, some legitimate, some not disclosed, so I don't want to give you names, you're intelligent. So India's number one news guy, whoever it is, was meeting him before he launched his network. My friend said to him, that if you, I'll give you a $100 million check, and he has written checks of 20, 30, 40 million to people. If you launch only a video platform, no channel, nothing, launch a video platform, and do it out of Singapore, because Singapore is, you can be more honest on Indian government, whichever government, doesn't matter. You know, all governments try to suppress it. I mean, we must not just put this government in dock. And whoever I go to raise capital for Business World, they talk of video. So investors, especially if they're American or European, they are so, they believe that the world is going to be only video. Of course, there's a charm of reading, but in terms of how millennials are consuming content, I think video is where the money is, because the audiences are there. So I think all of us publishers will have to become video publishers. That mindset over the next 3-5 years, where we believe there'll be no paper, there'll be no print. I mean, print will have its charm. There's a certain credibility to it. There's a certain filtering to it. But I think video is where the money is. Also, I want to tell you that we are relaunching Pitch, which is our marketing magazine that we launched 14 years back on 15th October 2003 at the Gallups. And one of Naval's friends asked us, he got very drunk, why are we launching Pitch? Why are we launching a cricket magazine? So I want to tell him that it is not, he's not in the room today, but we are relaunching Pitch on 27th. October, we have the Exchange for Media Conclave. This is the 14th edition of the Exchange for Media Conclave. We have global CEOs who are speaking there. We have Mr. Sanjeev Goenka, we have Mr. Velumani, we have Mr. Vaidyanathan from Capital First, we have Dr. Subhash Chandra. And on 1st December, we have the Exchange for Media Conclaves in South. For the first time, we are doing it in the South. I've been telling Sneha for many, many years to do it. Finally, we are doing it in South. So I just wanted to take this opportunity to get your attention and kind of seed it in your mind. 27th October at the Taj Santa Cruz in Bombay, and 1st December at the Shangri-La in Bangalore. So I just want to seed that because once you're on your mobile phone, you may block the ad. So I don't want to get the opportunity. So but now all yours. Please give it a big round of applause.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Mr. Sodhi requested you please stay back, and Anurag still needs to figure how to take a selfie, but till he figures that out, request for a memento for Mr. Sodhi. Request Mr. Batra to hand over this memento. Thank you for supporting the evening, and thank you for this very wonderful session.